Good morning all. Myself Anish Nag. I am from Government Polytechnic Chertala, Kerala. So today we will see a small topic on basic mechanical engineering, that is power transmission elements. Okay. So at the end of this session, you will understand what is power transmission elements. So what are some of the terminologies used for power transmission elements and the common type of power transmission elements used in mechanical engineering and the selection of how do we select a particular drive or a power transmission element for a particular application. So this is the again you will understand, you will appreciate these things, sir. Okay, so before going to details, sir, I will give some power transmission elements, sir, which will come under which category or which branch under mechanical engineering, that I will tell. So you know, mechanical engineering field are sub classified to different, like machine design, production, manufacturing, thermal, and so on. So this particular topic, it comes under machine design session. So under machine design, we have sub classifications like design of machine elements and design of power transmission elements. So design of machine elements, something related to the elements which will come under machine, and the power transmission elements, which will tell how do we transmit power from one place to another. Okay, so before going into details, I will ask one question. So how do we get power for the operation of a machine? For example, if you take the example of a flour mill, where we crush or where we grind some of the grains. So flour mill, how do we get power? The source of power, what is the source of power in a flour mill? So that is nothing but an electric motor. Electric motor is the source of power. Electric motor. Have you ever been to flour mill? So where we can see that the flour machine or flour milling machine is placed at some place. Say I put it as 2. Point 2 is the place for a machine, milling machine. And at the same time, this electric motor is placed at some distance apart. So it is at the point 1. Okay. So the power available at the motor, we have to transfer it into the machine. Okay. For that, we require an intermediate element. So this intermediate element we need. So these elements are called the power transmission elements. So it is nothing but an element which transfers power from an input side to an output side. So that is called a power transmission element. Before going to detailed study, you have to know some of the terminologies. You have to understand some of the terminologies. As I said, it has two sides. One is input side, the other one is output side. So the input side is called the driver side, and the output side is called the driven side. The side from which power is to be transmitted is called the driver side, and the side to which power is to be transmitted is called a driven side. Okay. So one more terminology you have to understand, that is velocity ratio. It is nothing but, so this is rotating with an angular velocity, say omega 1, and this is rotating with an angular velocity omega 2. So if you take the ratio of omega 2 and omega 1, okay, but that is called a velocity ratio. It is nothing but the ratio velocity of the driven side to velocity of the driver side. Okay. So next is some of the common examples for power transmission elements used in mechanical engineering, that is listed here: belt drive, chain drive, rope drive, gear drives, and friction drives. Okay, so I will explain some these things with some examples. So some of the applications are listed here. So flour mill, one application; elevator or crane is another application; bicycle is another application; motor vehicle is another application; precision machines is another application; our wrist watch is another application. So here the flour mills, we are using belt drive, and elevators we are using say rope drive, and here bicycle we are using chain drives, and motor vehicles we are using say gear drives, and here precision machines we are using friction drives, and wrist watch again we are using gear drives. Okay. So these are the power transmission elements which will transfer power. So similar way, I will ask one more question. Can we use chain drive instead of belt drives in flour mill? The answer is no. So there are certain criteria, sir. So that criteria will define which transmission element should be used for an application. So that criteria is distance between the shaft, condition under which it is used, velocity ratio or accuracy requirement, power to be transmitted. Okay, so the distance between shaft, so you can see here it will be at 6 meter or 3 meters apart up to. So that is moderate distance is the power transmission, then we can go for belt drive. And condition under which it is used, for high temperature application we cannot use belt drives, we have to go for chain drives. And velocity ratio, if you are interested in accuracy, you have to go for the gear drives, otherwise it will affect your performance. And power to be transmitted is the amount of power to be transmitted. So for example, elevator applications, the power to be transmitted is very high because we have to lift some 10 or 15 people from first floor to 10th floor. Okay, so that is another criteria. So this is the I am winding the session. So we have discussed what is power transmission element, what are the terminologies, what are the common type of power transmission elements, and what is the criteria for the selection of power transmission elements. Okay, thank you.